Okay. In chapter first we should know what is the difference between the distance and displacement. Is there anyone in the class who want to say me what is the distance and what is the displacement?
Yes.
Raise your hand. Raise your hand first. Okay. Ishan, answer.
When the area covered by a moving object in step with the temporal direction, the area covered by a object is called distance.
Don't try to read from the book. Try to understand what is the meaning of the distance and displacement. What is the actual meaning of distance and displacement? How can we find it? Don't define it. How can we explain the distance and displacement? Before vacations, I explained all these terms, distance and displacement. Okay, so the distance is the actual path covered by the ball is called distance. So if you start from here, suppose you start from here and you want to go to principal office, then the path you travel is called the distance. The actual path traveled by you is called the distance. This is the distance. And the displacement is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position is called the displacement. So, if you start from here, I'm carrying your hand now. So, the shortest distance between these two points is called the displacement. Clear? So, distance is the actual path of the body and the displacement is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position. Suppose you are moving in a circular path and you start from this point and again you reach to again this point. Then what is the distance covered by you? Suppose the radius of the circle is r. So what will be the distance covered by you? Yes, who is going to answer? Yes, sir.
2 pi r.
Very good. Your name?
Ayush.
Okay, Ayush. Good, Ayush. The actual power, the actual distance covered by you is 2 pi r. So this is the distance. And what is about the displacement? Yes, Ayush.
Zero.
Since you start from this point and again you are again this point here, it means the displacement, it means the shortest distance between the initial and the final position is zero here. So we will say the displacement is zero. Do you know the scalar the vector quantities? What are the scalar the vector quantities? Yes, Vidya.
The vector quantities are which are my direction and my magnitude.
Yes, which have magnitudes as well as directions. But the values which have only magnitude. What do you mean by magnitude? Magnitude means the actual quantity. Suppose you are saying that you start from this point and move along this path and again you are at the point B. So here you cover 500 meter. So you will say the 500 meter is the distance or value. This is the distance. The actual length of path is called distance. In this case, you have only the magnitude, that is the 500 meter. This is called the scalar quantity. Scalar quantity has only magnitude. Magnitude means some value. And the vector quantities are those which has magnitude as well as direction. So in case, suppose you start from here, the shortest distance between A and B is this one. So you can say that you are in east-south direction from the initial position. And at a distance of 200 meter. So here you are representing both the things, that is the distance and the distance as well as the direction. The distance between the initial and the final position is 200 meter, and the direction is also mentioned here. So in case if you have magnitude as well as direction is called the vector quantity. So displacement is a vector quantity, whereas distance is a scalar quantity. Clear? Okay. So, distance cannot be zero for a moving body. In this case, when you are moving a circular path, the actual distance for y is 2 pi r. Can't be zero. But the displacement can be zero. Yeah? If you start from any point, and again after traveling something distance, and you again come to that point, it means the displacement is zero here. So, you can say the distance cannot be zero for a moving body. But displacement can be zero. So these are the differences between the distance and displacement. Now, write up the question. Write the question. Now it is clear what is distance and what is displacement. Write up the question. difference between distance and displacement. Difference between distance and displacement. Difference between distance and displacement. And second one is scalar and vector quantities. Scalar and vector quantities. समझ में आ गया है? जिनको समझ में आ गया हाथ बताओ. That's good. So this is called distance and this is called displacement. What do you understand by motion? What do you mean by motion? Motion is?
This
is not a very good answer, Shyam. Yeah, we can say that if a body changes in position, with respect to any stationary body, we call it that the object is in motion. Suppose this is a tree and it starts from this point. And again, with respect to this tree, you change your position. So if a body changes its position with respect to any stationary object, this is called the body is in motion. So write down the question, what is motion? The answer of all these questions should be there in your notebook, huh? On Friday, yeah. Friday in your notebook. So again, speed. What do you mean by speed? What is the speed? What is the speed?
Distance.
I'm talking about the first chapter.
Distance upon time.
Yeah, we can say that the distance upon time is the speed. Or we can say the distance by the body per unit time. How much distance you are covering in a unit time is called speed. These are the very basic terms. If you are not aware about these terms, then how are you able to do the chapter number 4? So speed is a distance per the body per unit time is called speed. What is the S unit of speed? SI unit. It is meter per second. The correct way to answer is raise your hand first. So speed is the distance by the moving body per unit time is called speed. The SI unit of speed is meter per second. This is the SI unit of speed. And what is the large unit we use for measuring the speed? Kilometer per hour. Yes. This is the large unit we use for measuring the speed of a body. Suppose you are traveling in a bus, so you can't say that the bus is moving with the speed of 200 meter per second. You have to say it is moving with the certain like 30 kilometer per hour, 40 kilometer per hour. So the larger unit we use for measuring the speed is kilometer per hour. Now you know how can we convert the meter per second into kilometer per hour and vice versa?
Yes,
ma'am. So you ask me? Okay, very good. Your name? Karan. Yes, sir. I told you that you will revise this chapter first and then you will come here. What is the reason? If you have some questions, please ask question me. Please ask me some questions related to this chapter. Do you have some doubts on this chapter? No? I told you that if you have a doubt, then I will explain your questions. If you don't have any doubt, then you have to answer my questions. I told you, so only the 4 or 3 and 4 strings are there. You should to answer me. Then Ishan, and what's your name? Karan. Your name?
Amit.
And Ayush. Only 4 strings in the class is going to answer me. What are you doing? What's your name?
Anshika.
You did not learn this chapter first? Next class again. You have to revise the chapter first. First, clear your chapter motion. Okay? In term 1, you have 2 chapters in your syllabus, that is motion and the force and laws of motion. And for doing all other chapters like 2nd chapter, 3rd chapter, 4th chapter, 1st chapter should be clear. Okay? So next class, you will be very clear about chapter motion. Okay, beta, this answer.
Divided by.
Okay. Suppose you have some value like 10 meter per second. Now you have to convert it into kilometer per hour. What will you do? Okay. We will divide it by 1000 and multiply it. Now you want to convert. You have to convert second into hours. 16 to 60. Because in 1 second there is 1/16 to 60 hours. Yeah, this 16 to 60. Or simply we can say that by calculation we will get it 18/5. So it means if you want to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour. So in most of the cases you don't need to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour. So convert नहीं करना होता है, ठीक है? बस आपको आना चाहिए. So what will you do? You will multiply the value with 18/5. And if you want to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, in most of the question you have to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second because the associate of speed as well as the velocity is meter per second. तो क्योंकि स्पीड की और वेलोसिटी की असाइनमेंट मीटर पर सेकंड है तो आपको बहुत सारे केसेस में किलोमीटर पर आवर को मीटर पर सेकंड में कन्वर्ट करना पड़ता है. एंड फॉर कन्वर्जन ऑफ किलोमीटर पर आवर टू मीटर पर सेकंड व्हाट विल यू डू? यस, मल्टीप्लाई विद द 5.18. क्लियर? राइट द क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द स्पीड? व्हाट इज द स्पीड? Right, it is a unit. Right, it is a unit. Next question is, convert the following into meter per second. Next question is, convert the following into meter per second. First, 72 kilometer per hour. 72 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 36 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 54 किलोमीटर पर आवर इज एनीवन हैव डाउट इन दिस पार्ट्स? यू कैन कन्वर्ट द किलोमीटर पर आवर इनटू मीटर पर सेकंड. सिंपली यू विल मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 5.18. फॉर कन्वर्जन ऑफ किलोमीटर पर आवर इनटू मीटर पर सेकंड यू विल मल्टीप्लाई द नंबर विद 5.18. Okay. Okay. Next question is, how can you convert? Okay, sorry, not how can you convert the following into kilometer per hour. Next question is, convert the following into kilometer per hour. Question is 10 meter per second. At 25 meter per second. Next is average speed. Anyone know what is average speed? Average speed. Yes, sir. Total distance equal to total time. Okay. Good. For finding the average speed. Is equal to total distance upon total time. This is a formula for finding the average speed. Suppose a question is, first write the question, what is average speed? What is average speed? Now, write a question. A bus is moving at a speed of. This question is not clear. Question is, a bus is moving at a speed of 30 km per hour. For 2 hours. A bus is traveling with a speed of 30 km per hour for 2 hours. And again, 40 km per hour for 4 hours. A bus is traveling, first is not traveling with a speed of 30 km per hour for only 2 hours and then traveling with a 40 km per hour for again another 4 hours. In question, you have to find that question. Find average speed of the bus. Anyone like to try this question? How will you calculate it? Very good. What's your name? Karan. Good, Karan. Good.
Okay.
Yes, yes, yes. It's good. Karan, it's very good. Actually, we know that for finding the average speed, we should know total distance and total time. We have the values of total time, but we don't have total distance. We have speed. So first, you will find the distance in first and the second cases. Ayush, is it visible? Okay. So first, you will find out the distance covered by the bus in first 2 hours. So you will write the answer like this. Speed is 30 km per hour. Time is, it is 2 hours. How can you find distance?
30
upon time. Speed is equal to distance upon time. And distance is equal to speed multiplied with the time. Okay? So distance will be speed multiplied with the time. 30 into 2, it will be 60 km. So for finding the average speed, you should know total distance as well as the total time. You have total time, but you don't have the value of total distance. So what will you do? First, you will calculate the distance in the first case. And again, the distance for the second case. For the second case, you have the speed is 40 km per hour. And time is 4 hours. So the distance will be 40 into 4, it will be 160 km. Is it clear or not? So first, you will find a total distance. By using this speed, you can't find out the average speed of the bus. You should know total distance, you should know total time, and then you will find the average speed. So, total distance is now, I'm doing this question here now. Total distance is equal to how much? 60 plus 160 will be? Okay, it will be 220 km. And the total time is?
7.
It is 2 plus 4, it is? Not 7 km, it is 6 hours. Enough? And the average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. That is 220 upon 6 hours. 110 upon 3. You can find out in decimal. 3 are 9. 18.67 km per hour. Is it clear? Question is clear? So for finding the average speed, first you will find total distance and then total time and then you can find the average speed. So average speed nikali ke hum speed se average speed nahi nikal sakte. Aapko average speed nikalne ke liye pehle total distance nikalna padega, total time nikalna padega, tabhi aap average speed nikal sakte. Theek hai? Okay? Try to answer the question. From NCERT, you have to blue column of page number 100. Yes, 100. Blue column of page number 100. This is your giving your homework. And in case of any doubt, you can ask me in your next class. Clear? Okay, Divya? You're Divya. Okay, she's Divya. And you know?
Janvi.
Janvi, okay, Janvi. So, Janvi, in case of any doubt, you can ask me next class. Huh? Next here, view column of page number 102. These are homework questions. Bache, grab the page number. View column of page number 102. Do you know what is the speedometer and odometer? No, see, raise your hand first. Okay, Sharan, Ayush, and your name was Amit. Yes, Amit. So, yes, Amit.
What speedometer we use to measure the speed and
at any state of time? Very good. Sit down. The speedometer, in your vehicles, you have two type of meters. One, which gives the distance, how much distance you cover. And other one, in which you can see what is your speed. What is the speed of your vehicle? So, speedometer is an instrument which used to measure the speed at any state of time. Which used to measure the speed of the object at any state of time. And okay, Ayush, what is odometer?
Which distance? Which the measure distance?
Yeah. The other meter you use in a vehicle is the odometer, in which you find out how much distance he hasn't covered. So odometer measures the distance of the vehicle. How much distance you cover, it can measure. This instrument is used to measure the distance covered by the moving body. So, writing the question, what is the speedometer and odometer?
Class.